Well, this is a 25th anniversary, I was told, so we brought like a show we have in America that we've never had over in Europe before. So we wanted to make this show special for Wacken because it's special for us to be here again and be part of the 25th anniversary. So it's going to be, you know, a one-of-a-kind Slayer show for Europe.
This is 25 years of metal madness. I think that's awesome. I never would imagine that I'd be sitting here or having anybody say, what's it like being together for 33 years, 35 years? That's metal. You know what I mean? It's persistence and patience. And that's what metal's about. I mean, because that's how it was with us. When we started, nobody really cared, but we were persistent. We were going to make people listen to what we do.
You know, when I was starting out on our first couple records, you know, I thought I'd be retired by the time I was 40, you know, because I thought 40 was old. And it's a different generation these days, and I'm just turned 50 recently, and I don't feel old. You know, you get a little more aches and pains than you used to, but, you know, I still feel we put on a great show, and the music stands for itself. The stuff from the 80s, 90s, the stuff we're doing now. You know, and we're one of those bands that were lucky enough to jump generations. You know, it's not cool if your parents like it and your kids like it. We're one of those bands that it is. And that's very lucky. There's no formula. Just, I guess it's having a 30-year career and not disappointing your fans. And therefore, you know, teenagers are into it. People that were into it from Show No Mercy are still into it. I mean, it's when we do, like, sometimes in between festivals, use some club dates. When you do the club dates, you never know what you're going to get, because if the older fans are paying attention, they bought up all the tickets. So you look out there and there's like 700 people that look like my dad. I'm like, are they here for the right show? But we're very lucky.
There's love and passion. And the music that I create and the songs that I put together and help put together, there's a lot of love and passion that goes into it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here. Just 30 years. That's a long time. 30 years is a really long time. You know, and the passion is why I've done this for so many years. Whenever we come up with ideas or song ideas, I never look into what the song's meaning really is, you know. I read it. If it reads well, it's cool. I'm okay with it. Later on is when, you know, when the more I sing it, the more it, you know, more of what the song's meaning is, I guess, will come to light. But I don't really pay attention to it. My best guess is that with the title "Implode," it means it's obviously exploding from within. So maybe the world's gone doing these things. It's about the world and how it's going to self-implode eventually because of all the stupid things that are going on. You know what I mean? And today, right now, there's some really crazy shit going on. You know what I mean? And everybody's involved. You know what I mean? It didn't take much. It took, I shouldn't say it didn't take much because it was a big deal. The plane going down, they shot down that plane. And it had so many people from many parts of the world on it. And I'm amazed that the world hasn't done more. That's what surprises me. The world hasn't gotten to come together and done more to say, listen, you can't be doing this kind of shit. This is really fucked up, you know, and stepped up.
You know, we put out Implode at the Golden Gods in America, whenever that was, March, I don't know, April. And, you know, people would tell me, I never go online and see what people are talking about because people are 10 foot tall behind a computer screen, you know. But, you know, a lot of it was positive. A lot of people said, for anybody that was worried about what Slayer was going to sound like post-Hanneman, don't worry about it, you know. And that's, I know people are going to think that. People are going to expect us to fail because it's a first record without Jeff. I get it. But I'm also very proud of what we've done so far towards new material. It's fast. The slow stuff's heavy. I mean, it's everything that people like Slayer for in the past is on this record.
Dance at the dead of my dream. Listen to their hallowed scream. The dead have taken my soul. Temptation has lost all control. Dead! Scared! We'll be right back.
It's not like if you're an athlete getting signed to a big deal, because then you know you're guaranteed money for a few years. And a musician is not. Just because you get your first album doesn't mean you're going to have a second one, let alone a third. The one thing we splurge on ourselves, we buy first class or business class, because if we don't come, like I said, we arrived here yesterday. If we don't get some sleep on that plane, we're going to be in no shape to play a show.
It's never really been about the money, because we would have a private jet if it was about money. But we're not about money. We're about, you know, working hard and playing the music that we like, that we love, and we're fortunate that 75,000 kids enjoy and love it too. You know what I mean? And they're the ones that have allowed us to be around for 30 years. So I think that's awesome.
Yeah, my life rocks. I'm totally happy. Slayer is my life, and we ain't going anywhere soon.
Yeah!